All right, I've started a new page here with my current graph and the current flow that I know. So let me create our residual graph now for this current network flow. So S A C B D E T, all the right nodes. Okay, I've got one more I can go forward from S to A, and then two I can undo. I can't go forward A to B, so that's a one I can undo. B to T, nothing forward, I could undo two. S to C, I could go forward with one, and I can undo two. C to B, I've got nothing left to go forward, but I could undo that one. C to D, nothing left to go forward, but I can undo that one. D to T, nothing left to go forward, but I can undo that one, two. A to D, nothing to go forward, but I can undo that, one for that one. C to E, I could go forward with one. And E to T, I could go forward with two. Okay, let's compute our augmenting path here if we've got one. S to A won't work because there are only in edges there. S to C, yeah, that's okay. And then I can't go here, but I can go here to E, and then E to T. So here is my augmenting path right here. It's S, C, E, T. Okay, the bottleneck equals the min of 1, 1, and 2. So the bottleneck equals 1. So let's go ahead and redraw my new graph where I update the flows using this value right here. So I've got S, A, C, B, D, E, T, and of course the directions have to be the same as are given in my original graph because I can't change the directions. What I'm looking to change are what's the actual flow being put on those edges. Okay, so any edge that is not involved in the augmenting path stays the same. So S to A is 2 out of 3, A to B is 1 out of 1, B to T is 2 out of 2, C to B is 1 out of 1, A to D is 1 out of 1, D to T is 2 out of 2. Okay, now for the edges that change, I'm adding a 1 to this flow right here, so I have 3 out of 3, right? I'm adding this flow of 1 right here onto this edge right here, so that's 3 out of 3. And then I have, C to D is unchanged because that's not involved in the augmenting path, so let me write that down before I forget it again. C to E is on my augmenting path, so that means bottleneck plus whatever the current flow was, 1 plus 0, over capacity 1, and then E to T is on the augmenting path, so that's bottleneck plus the current flow, which is 0 over 2. Okay, so there's my updated flow, and I'm not quite positive I'm done yet, so let's go ahead and copy that and move to a new page and see if I can find another augmenting path. All right, there's the copy of our graph as it stands now. Here's our residual graph for that. So I have S, S, A, C, B, D, E, T. All right, I can push forward with 1 and push back with 2. I can push back here with 1, A to B. B to T, nothing to go forward, but I can push back with 2. A to D, nothing to go forward, push back of 1. D to T, nothing forward, but a push back of 2. S to C, nothing forward, but I've got available a push back of 3. C to B, nothing to go forward, but I can push back 1. C to E, nothing forward, but I can do push back a 1. E to T, I could go forward with 1, or I can do a push back of 1. See, that's what I have right there. Okay, and then I have C to B, nothing forward, but I could push back one. Okay, let us look for an augmenting path. S to A is possible, but I'm stuck there. And in fact, I'm stuck. There is no augmenting path. Just to show you, I could end up at T right here. The only way to end up at T is right here from E, but there's nothing coming into E that'll get me back to S. So there is no augmenting path, so I'm done. And this right here is my answer. Okay, let's run through this and make sure that conservation is satisfied. I can see that my, let's see, coming into A, I have 2. Coming in, going out of A, I have 1 plus 1. Great. Coming into B, I have 1 plus 1. That gives 2. Going out of B, I have 2. So A and B are okay. Coming into C, I have 3. Going out of C, I have 1 plus 1 plus 1. So C is okay. Coming into D, I have 1 plus 1 is 2. Going out of D, I have 2. So D is okay. Coming into C, I have 1. Going out of C, I have 1. So E is okay. And then coming into T, I'm not worried about conservation because it doesn't apply for a sink node right here. And I can see my capacities are greater than or equal to my actual flow, so everything is okay at T. Again, same thing at S. I'm not exceeding my capacities, so I'm good. So it's a reasonable network flow.